we're seeing an epidemic of cancer. We're seeing dogs getting cancer earlier than 20 years ago. So it's a good time to be doing a study like this.
This is a landmark study. This, looking back, will be a seminal piece of work that will change canine health for many, many decades to come.
The Golden Retriever Lifetime Health Study is a pivotal study for veterinary medicine because it'll give us the information we need to be able to make evidence-based recommendations to pet owners so that their animals can live longer, healthier lives.
It's the largest and longest study ever attempted like this in veterinary medicine. Human studies have done longitudinal studies looking at people for more than 60 years, but this is the first time that this has ever been attempted in the world of veterinary medicine.
Ultimate impact and really the holy grail is preventive medicine. But to be able to make those recommendations, we need to have scientifically based evidence so that we can make the recommendations to pet owners so that they can make decisions for the betterment of their animals. That's when we can have the impact.
Being involved in the study with the Morris Foundation is quite an honor for both myself, and I think Ranger's pretty proud also.
We knew we wanted to get a golden retriever puppy. So when we picked Piper up, we waited till she was 6 months old and we got her enrolled.
We're gonna have 3,000 golden retrievers that we'll be following through the study. We'll be able to do some accurate statistical analysis and know what the incident rate is of cancer in this group and be able to compare that to the larger population of dogs to see if in fact it is a change in the incident rate, or are we in fact just becoming more aware of it, more diagnosis?
In about 2007, we held a very large cancer congress, and out of that came the concept of actually doing a lifetime longitudinal study. So we began thinking about a population of dogs that we could monitor for a very long time to understand what the impact of their exposures, their diet, their history, all of the things that happened to them would have on their health.
We chose the Golden Retriever for two primary reasons. One, they do have a higher incidence of cancer than many other breeds. It's thought that about 60% of Golden Retrievers will get some form of cancer during their life. They're a very popular breed, and to get 3,000 dogs to participate in a study like this, we needed to choose a popular breed. So the combination of the popularity with the high incidence of cancer made the Golden Retriever a good choice for the study.
We began to think about what sort of information we wanted to collect, and we actually ended up building a very extensive questionnaire.
It's an intensive questionnaire. It does ask questions about the dog's environment, the types of treats the dog's eating, all sorts of things you wouldn't naturally think of.
We've got show dogs, we've got dogs that are out doing hunt tests and field trials every weekend, and we've got plenty of dogs that live in the backyard with five kids and eat macaroni and cheese and hot dogs every weekend. So we have 3,000 dogs in the effort to try to get as many diverse lifestyles as possible.
The emphasis of this study is really on the owner's responsibility to participate. We ask for just an enormous amount of information.
We signed up for the study knowing full well that it would require real attention on Piper and any changes in Piper's health and any vet visits throughout the year.
I've lost two other Goldens to different forms of Golden Retriever cancer and just was eager to try to give back.
A lot of our stories have dealt with owners that have lost previous Golden Retrievers to cancer, and a lot of them have lost young dogs to cancer, which is particularly difficult to see. We have a significant amount of sibling littermates in the study, so it'll be interesting to see that genetic aspect.
Over the course of, the 10-year project, we may have four or five generations of dogs that would be very, very valuable in terms of looking at what the influence from the mother to the child might be.
It's our hope that we have a better understanding at the end of this study what are the important risk factors for cancer, that this will be the first of many more studies done on canine cancer, that this study will focus future studies in a certain area.
sure, we're studying golden retrievers, and you know, that benefits dogs like Winston and other golden retrievers, but really what we stand to learn in golden retrievers can benefit all dogs. So if we can find a genetic signature in the golden, then the question is, well, what other breeds also display those genetic signatures that may put those breeds at risk?
We have big hopes. We think we will identify a tremendous amount of information that will be useful to people not only now but in the future. And this is a study that gets more and more valuable as time goes on.
A diagnostic tool for cancer would be one thing. Another that I would love to see would be a genetic test that we could do on golden retrievers and identify that they've got a certain gene that makes them more susceptible to a certain kind of cancer.
A study of this magnitude takes a tremendous amount of resources, and it's really only made possible by the sponsors, which include Morris Animal Foundation, Blue Buffalo, which is a pet food company, and the Petco Foundation.
To be able to give back and really contribute to, you know, hopefully improving the health of golden retrievers specifically, but dogs as a whole.
Honestly, Winston lives in our house. In fact, he sleeps in our bedroom. From time to time, he probably sleeps in the bed. Don't tell my husband, because he's generally that happens when he's not home. But you know, they share our environment, and as a result of that, their lifespans are shorter than ours. But the health problems that they develop can be indicators of health problems that we may develop as well, and so that also is really important.
If we can participate in any way to learn something about cancer and to learn something about the health issues that Goldens face, and if in any way that can translate into the human world, we will have been very proud to have participated in it long after Piper is no longer with us.